In the wilds of southern Norway, endangered Arctic foxes are struggling to find enough food to eat. Climate change has made the foxes' rodent prey more scarce. That's why scientists breeding these endangered animals in captivity have also set up more than 30 feeding stations across the wilderness. It's a rare and controversial step in conservation circles. But without such feeding programs, some say the animals would go extinct.
If we stop the feeding now, we would see a decrease in the population sizes, and that would be really detrimental.
The Arctic fox has long been a symbol of the far north. Foxes were driven to near extinction across Scandinavia by hunters seeking their winter white fur. Hunting bans and protections introduced in the 1920s and 30s gave them some reprieve. But now they're facing a new invisible enemy. Arctic foxes need to hunt enough lemmings to make it through long winters. But scientists say warming temperatures have caused rodent populations to fall in recent years. Conservation biologist Christine Ulvand explains.
If we get warmer and more unstable climate where you get snow melt and you get icing on the ground, that is going to affect how well the rodents can survive.
So as part of the state-sponsored program to restore Arctic foxes, Norway has been feeding the population for nearly 20 years at an annual cost of roughly $300,000. The Norwegian Institute for Nature Research is managing the program.
In the mountain areas where we have released foxes, and also in stepping stone areas in between the release sites, we have feeding stations for the Arctic foxes. Those are made up of standing barrels with a laying barrel where the foxes can go in. And then in the last standing barrel, we have standard dog pellets that we fill into it and that the foxes eat.
Since 2006, the program has helped to boost the fox population from as few as 40 to around 550 across Scandinavia. But feeding animals to ensure a population survives, known as supplementary feeding, can be contentious. It can propagate diseases among the population, as animals cluster around feeding stations where pathogens can spread. Some scientists also question whether it makes sense to support animals in landscapes that can no longer sustain them. But others say feeding programs are necessary to prevent extinctions.
I think we've come a long way in saving this species. We've already seen that the population is rising. We're getting larger subpopulations, and we're getting more exchange of individuals between populations. But I still think we have some way to go before we can say that we've really saved the species.